Good morning. This is Dr. عادل بندق, Professor of Anatomy and Neuroscience, Mansoura University, Egypt. Today I will talk about the cervical or cervical sympathetic chain. Okay, I will talk about the location, formation, and distribution. Regarding the location, it is located behind the carotid sheaths in front of the prevertebral muscles. Formation, it is formed by three ganglia, superior, middle, and inferior cervical ganglia. Actually, there are 8 cervical nerves, and each nerve should have a corresponding cervical ganglion. So we should have 8 cervical ganglion. The upper 4 cervical ganglia are fused to form the superior cervical ganglion. C5 and C6 cervical ganglia are fused to form the middle cervical ganglion, and the C7 and the C8 are fused to form the inferior cervical ganglion. Therefore, the superior cervical ganglion is formed by the fusion of the upper 4 cervical ganglia, so it is the largest. The middle cervical ganglion, it is formed by the fusion of C5 and C6 cervical ganglia, and the inferior cervical ganglion is formed by the fusion of C7 and C8 cervical ganglia. Regarding the branches or distribution, the branches are distributed by 3 roots. The first root is along the cervical nerves. Second root is along the arteries, vascular, along the blood vessels. And the third root is direct distribution. The middle cervical ganglion and the inferior cervical ganglion are connected by a loop called ansa subclavia. So ansa subclavia is a loop connecting the middle and the inferior cervical ganglia. The inferior cervical ganglion is usually fused with the first thoracic ganglion to form one ganglion called the stellate ganglion. So the stellate ganglion is the fused inferior cervical ganglion and the first thoracic ganglion. Regarding the distribution of the sympathetic fibers or the branches of the cervical ganglia, first along nerves. Superior cervical ganglion gives the branches along the upper 4 cervical nerves and along the last 4 cranial nerves. The middle cervical ganglion gives the branches along C5 and C6 cervical nerves. The inferior cervical ganglion gives the branches along C7 and C8 cervical nerves. So, the first distribution is along the nerves. Second distribution along arteries. The superior cervical ganglion gives the branches along the internal carotid artery to form the internal carotid plexus. It also gives the branches along the external carotid artery to form the external carotid plexus. The middle cervical ganglion gives the branches along the inferior thyroid artery to form the inferior thyroid plexus. The inferior cervical ganglion gives the branches along the subclavian artery to form the subclavian plexus. The third route of distribution is direct branches. Each ganglion gives a cardiac branch to the cardiac plexuses, but the superior gives a branch to the pharyngeal plexus. It's called the pharyngeal branch. So the superior cervical ganglion gives the pharyngeal branch to the pharyngeal plexus and also gives the cardiac branch to the cardiac plexuses. The middle cervical ganglion gives the cardiac branch to the cardiac plexuses, and the inferior cervical ganglion also gives cardiac branch to the cardiac plexuses. So if we talk about the distribution of the superior cervical ganglion along nerves, along arteries, and direct branches along nerves, with the upper 4 cervical nerves, and with the last four cranial nerves. Vascular distribution along the internal carotid artery and along the external carotid artery, direct branches, pharyngeal branch, and the cardiac branch. Regarding the middle cervical ganglion, it gives the branches along the nerves, along the C5 and C6. It also gives the vascular branch along the inferior thyroid artery and the direct branch, cardiac branch, to the cardiac plexuses. The inferior cervical ganglion gives also three routes of distribution. The first route along nerves, along C7 and C8, cervical nerves, and along artery, along the subclavian artery, to form the subclavian plexus and direct branch, cardiac branch, to the cardiac plexuses. Regarding lesion of the cervical sympathetic chain, lesion or injury of the cervical sympathetic chain causes Horner's syndrome. And Horner's syndrome has four cardinal signs. The first one, incomplete ptosis. And this incomplete ptosis is due to paralysis of the first molar muscle, which is a part of the levator palpebrae superioris. Second sign is meiosis. Meiosis, constriction of the pupil due to paralysis of the dilator pupillae muscle. Third sign, anhidrosis, due to paralysis of the sweat glands of the face. And the fourth sign is enophthalmos, sunken eye, due to paralysis of the third molar muscle, which closes the inferior orbital fissure. So the four cardinal signs of Horner's syndrome: incomplete ptosis due to paralysis of the first molar muscle, meiosis, constriction of the pupil due to paralysis of the dilator pupillae muscle, anhidrosis, dry skin of the face due to paralysis of the sweat glands, enophthalmos, sunken eye due to paralysis of the third molar muscle, which closes the inferior orbital fissure. This is a photo of Horner's syndrome. This is right side Horner's syndrome. Okay, this is incomplete ptosis, and this is meiosis. Another photo, this is left side Horner's syndrome, incomplete ptosis and meiosis. And thank you very much. Best wishes and good luck.